In this video, we're going to solve a limit problem. Limit of 1 plus sine of pi square root 1 plus 4n squared all to the power n as n goes to infinity. Now, how to solve this question? We're going to start from here, the sine. So here sine of a pi, then square root 1 plus 4n squared. Because sine has a period of 2 pi, so then it equals sine right down the inside then minus n times 2 pi is period. So next, take the common factor pi. In here, just sine of pi. In here, just square root 1 plus 4n squared minus 2n. Because we want to get rid of the square root, so then we time its conjugate. So then its conjugate, just the square root 1 plus 4n squared, then here minus, then here plus 2n. Then the bottom times the same term. Then just square root 1 plus 4n squared, then plus 2 pi, 2n. Now here it's like a minus b times a plus b. Then equals a squared minus b squared. So now let's simplify this part. And here, just sine of pi, and here just the first one squared, that's 1 plus 4n squared, then the second one squared, then minus 4n squared, then this is the denominator. So then here divided by this one, 1 plus 4n squared plus 2n. Then these two canceled. So then we have the following. That's sine on top, just pi. So on top, pi, and on the bottom, here, just 1 plus 4n squared, then plus 2n. So next, we're going to define this part as xn. So the xn equals this part. That's a pi over square root 1 plus 4n squared plus 2n. So that means here we can just write it as sine of xn. So now let's take a look. So we start from here. So now just equals sine of xn. So let's write down this result. So then we have sine of pi, the square root, then equals this part. Then equals sine of xn. So now let's take a look. As n goes to infinity, because here on top, just pi, the constant, on top we have n. So then as n goes to infinity, so xn goes to 0. And here, xn approaches 0. Because xn approaches 0 as n goes to infinity, so then sine of xn is also approaches 0 as n goes to infinity. So now let's start the original question, the limit. So now let's see here. So then here, the limit as n goes to infinity. So here, 1 plus sine of pi square root, then all to the power n. So next, we could use sine of xn to replace this part. So limit n goes to infinity here, 1 plus sine of xn, then to the power of n. Then how to solve this limit? Then we can do this. Then here, it's 1 plus sine of xn. Because sine of xn goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. Same thing for xn goes to 0. So then we're going to do this. So on top, we're going to put 1 over the exponent, 1 over sine of xn. Then here, because on the bottom we have a sine of xn, so here we're going to put sine of xn. Then on the bottom, we're going to put xn. Then we have xn on the bottom, so here we're going to put the xn. So you see here, x sine of xn, these two canceled just 1. So then the original exponent just n. So then here, we need to put n here. So next, we need to figure out when n goes to infinity, what's the limit of each part? So this is the first part, so the exponent, the second part, then third part. Okay, we need to figure out the limit for each part. So this is the second part, this is the third part. So let's do one by one. Let's see the first part. And here, the limit as n goes to infinity. So here, 1 plus sine of xn to the power 1 over sine of xn. Because we have this result, so that's the limit as x goes to 0, then 1 plus x to the power 1 over x equals e. So now let's see what's here. Because as n goes to infinity, sine of xn goes to 0. So that's why, based on this result, so then this one just equals e. So that is the first part. So that means this one approaches e. So now let's see what's the limit as n goes to infinity of this part. Okay, so now this is the first part. So now let's see the second part. The second part is the limit as n goes to infinity of sine of xn over xn. Because we have this result, so that's the limit as x goes to 0, sine of x over x equals 1. So then you see when n goes to infinity, sine of xn goes to 0. So that's why based on this result, so then this one just equals 1. So that's the result for the second part. So that means, so this exponent approaches 1. Now let's see the third part. Okay, so now let's see what's the limit of xn times n. Because xn just pi over square root 1 plus 4n squared then plus 2n, then here times n. So next, so let's see the limit. So top and bottom divided by n. So on top, then just pi. Then on the bottom here, divided by n, so this one, that's 1 over n squared. This one just 4. Then here, just 2. Then as n goes to infinity, so this one is a 0. So this is square root of 4, that's 2. The bottom, just 4. So then we have the 4 pi over 4. That is the result for the third part. So that means, so the limit for the third part, so this one approaches pi over 4. So now let's see the result. Okay, so this is the original question, the limit. So then we have this part approaches e, so exponent, this one's 1, this one's pi over 4. So now let's write down the answer, the result. So then here's the limit. As n goes to infinity, and here 1 plus sine of pi square root 1 plus 4n squared, then all to the power n, then just equals the e to the power, the first part is 1, then the second part is pi over 4. So then the answer, just e to the pi over 4. That is the answer for this question. Thanks for watching.